Hello everyone, and welcome to a special LP. It's a buddy LP, and I am Infernocanuck, and of course, my buddy, or I am his buddy, is Galagoth. Say hi, Galagoth.
Hey, everybody.
Hey. All right, so yeah, we're doing this for the Voltron Army, the contest that they have going on there. They invite LPers to LP with other LPers as much as possible. And since our joint love is this Third Age Total War mod for Medieval 2 Total War, you can't really... it's not really a two-player game. So we're going to do a campaign mode, and I am going to be the sucker that controls this. However, Galagoth is going to be the brains of the operation. He's the brains and I'm more the brawn, right, man?
Mwahaha,
see? As a brain would say. Anyway, what we're playing is the dwarf faction in Middle Earth, and our poor empire has been split into twain. And sure enough, in Kibil Doom. Oh, also, I think Galagoth is going to be our the pronunciation master, because I'm gonna slaughter this, by the way. So, you know, have fun with that. Anyways, Gimli, the infamous Gimli. John Rhys Davies is over here on, like, the far, 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 far west coast.
I feel bad for his career after Lord of the Rings.
Oh, really? What happened to him? Well, like, maybe that's
really
the reason. What happened to
been
him?
Been in anything good lately.
Aww. Really?
Like, I've only been seeing him on, like, sci-fi originals.
Aww. That sucks. Hey, I used to play... I popped in Dune 2000, and he was, like, one of the leaders of House Atreides. It was kind of hilarious. Anyway, Gimli and his crew are representing the west side, and then the king of the dwarves in Erebor, which is a effin' mountain. Look at that shit. That's awesome. Anyways, they're representing the company from the east side. So we got east side, west side, but unlike a rapper's war, they're going to work together.
They're not shooting each other.
Yeah, they're not shooting each other. They're not hurling axes at each other. And by the way, hopefully, if you're lucky in this LP, you'll get to see yourself a bearded dwarven woman. That's right. Anyways, how about less talky, more actually doing something? How does that sound, dude?
We already have an army in the field.
We already have an army? What? Do we have an army in the field? I'm just trying to remember what happened when we last left off when we played.
I think we sieged a goblin encampment.
You are absolutely right. We took Dane's Halls. We retook Dane's Halls. With Borin. Oh yeah, Borin is kind of insane.
Meat shield!
He's our meat shield. Who's got a meat shield? This guy's got a meat shield. Alright. Sexy. He's extravagant, too. Alright.
Oh, the other guy died.
Yeah, the other guy. Oh, yeah, he did. Yeah, we had two dwarven leaders. Oh, yes, and we had a spy, so we're going to check out what's going on further west. So what do you think, Galagoth? Should we keep on... should we head west, young man, or should we go north?
Well, our strategy right now should probably be a two-pronged attack.
Ooh, two-pronged attack. I like it. Where shall our prongs be?
Well, in the western sector.
Yeah.
We need to hit the orcs of Gunbad.
Okay.
Because they have in their possession the birthplace of the dwarven race, and well, we can't let that stand.
I agree. I concur, good sir. I concur. Awesome. So whereabout is it? where is this place in Middle Earth? Is it here?
Okay, right here we have a rebel territory. And if we move a little bit to the east a bit.
Uh-huh.
North a little bit.
Oh, up here?
Yeah, this territory, these areas.
Oh.
This is the heartland of the Orcs of Gunbad.
Is it? Well,
yeah, these are the guys who killed the Northern Numerian Kingdom.
What? Really? Okay, time to get...
Yeah,
okay,
like,
so
the Witch King was all, like, up in that business.
Up in their grill, so to speak?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, he was there with his crew, and they were all like, yo, homie.
We should probably stop with the rapper talk. We're probably, like, the two whitest guys
yes.
out here.
Yeah.
Alright, so let's recruit an army in Kibil Doom and Thorin's Halls. So what should we get?
I'm thinking our general should be Gimli.
We have Dwarven Miners in the halls, and we have Axe Throwers and Dwarven Warriors.
Ooh, Axe Throwers.
Okay, so let's do two Axe Throwers to start us off for this turn.
Axe Throwers will be good.
Yeah.
And then we're going to get some Warriors.
Perfect.
So that's going to be our main recruiting area right now.
Yeah, Kibble Doom? All right, awesome. Now, how big of an army should we get, do you think?
I'm going to say near 1,000 at least.
Okay, near 1,000 men. I like it. So at least...
Just so we can take a bit more casualties.
So at least maybe about 10 units, 10, 12 units?
Yeah.
Perfect. And we'll probably lead it by Gimli, right? Because he's effing awesome and he should actually do something.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah, considering the only thing he's done so far was make a tower.
Yep, that's all he did is he made that tower. We will call it Gimli's Tower, and it shall last forever. Okay, so I think for the rest of it, until we're done recruiting that army, we should just have everything be status quo over here, right?
Yeah.
And have this army kind
of... Because that group just took that place, and it's kind of battered.
Yeah, it is kind of battered. It's kind of battered and bruised, which means we can actually build something. Should we build ourselves a pig farm, a brewery, or maybe something actually responsible like a garrison quarters?
Probably garrison quarter because we need to retrain those troops.
Yeah, agreed. Sir, you are a genius.
Pig factory.
You're a genius because I agree with you. If you disagree with me, you will be an idiot. Nah, just kidding. Far from it. If anything, I will be the idiot. Okay, so we're pretty much almost all out of the monies, so we might as well just end this turn. Our spy... didn't you just say something about Gunbad?
That's a town over them.
But that's not their homeland, is it?
No. Their homeland is Kurandin.
Oh, Kurandin, which used to be our homeland.
Yes.
Oh, not for long.
The Witch King made a little fortress there and was all like, I'm going to take out Northern Numerians.
Yeah, yo. Oh, wait. We said we weren't going to do that. Okay, let's end the turn.
Yeah. We talked about this.
We talked about this already. Damn it.
Do I need the sock puppets?
Oh, no sock puppets. I'll understand without sock puppets. Oh, also, for those of you who don't know this mod, pretty much Sauron, the Dark Lord, is the Pope. In the sense that he has a little popometer, and he tells all the bad evil factions what to do, right? Is that right, Galagoth?
Yep. Yes, it is.
Okay.
Now just imagine Sauron with the Pope.
Oh my God, that's blasphemy! Oh, hereticalicious. Okay, so we have a candidate for adoption. Should we take this guy, or should we have our king actually birth his own son? Well, he already has a few sons. One that died. Bombor. Poor Bombor.
I think... You see the youngest one on the bottom there?
The Bombor, the one male? That died?
No. Down
that
one
guy?
Row.
Narf?
That looks like someone from, like, Dragon
It does. Age. It actually... I think that is the portrait of... what's his face? Corgan? No, not Corgan. Derp? That's Mass Effect. No, yeah, the Drunken Dwarf. That is totally his thing.
Yeah.
It's totally him. Anyway, should we take this dude? He is a confident attacker, brave, promising commander, eager, speaks of loyalty, he's obedient, and he wins first, damn it.
Check our money.
Our monies?
Our income right now.
Our monies are, we're making about 32, 33 profit.
Okay, we can afford him.
We can afford him? Alright, congratulations. Frore, we can afford you. Now, where does he show up? Oh, he's with the king. Oh, well. He can chill with the king, I suppose. Okay. So, now we have 26... Oh, wow, they're like 500 each, eh? That's insane.
Well, they are pretty good.
You're right, they are pretty good. Okay, so we don't need any miners, of course. Because they're too young. Lulz. So we have 3 axe throwers right now, and 1 Dwarven Warrior... Dwarven Warrior, and 2 Dwarven Miners. So what do you think? Oh, we can't do any more Axe Throwers, so more Warriors, I suppose?
Yeah, Warriors.
Warriors! Come out and play!
Play, yay!
This is ridiculous. I love this. I love this. Okay. Also, one of the qualifiers for this thing is to, like, prove that both of you have fun, and I think we've just proven it right now. When you start bringing up the Warriors references, I think you're safe. There's not really much else. It's really kind of just burning turns, right? Right now, until we mass that army, isn't it? Because yeah, the dwarves...
Then we have to retrain our eastern force so we can continue on the crusade
we have to wait. Oh, yes, the Sauron, like... Yeah, he calls crusades too, right? Aren't they called invasions?
Yeah, they're called invasions. The first one is going to be against Rohan.
Brutal.
Pretty soon, actually, I cool. think.
Spoiler alert. Hello, Gunbad. I wonder if you're related to Strongbad. Oh, Snaga. Stupid Snaga. And a stupid, ugly general with your ugly, ugly face. Alright. Should we actually send this spy, Nar, up towards said homeland?
Yeah, so we can scope out our plan of attack.
I like it. I like it a lot. Okay, I don't want to bore people with this, so we will just end the turn, I suppose. Oh, wait, we could probably build something. We should probably build something, shouldn't we? Okay,
yeah.
What we got?
Let's see what we can make.
Kibil Doom can't do shit. This guy's already building something, so there's no point. Actually, we can probably just queue up something now, really. What should we develop, do you think? Erebor, maybe. Our capital? I don't know. Dane's Halls, maybe? Maybe we'll queue up a Boyer in the Dane's Halls, because that way we can recruit our...
Yeah, that way you can get the extras.
Yeah, okay, let's do that. Perfect. And I can't...
Oh, dang, their population
is
low.
Is it really low? Yeah, that's because we executed all of them. I remember that.
Oh,
all
yeah.
Goblin blood ran that day. It ran. Actually, you know what? Since we have the
second
money...
Second thought, we probably shouldn't have done that.
Yeah, probably not, but what can you do? It's not Rome Total War,
Wars
so...
Wars reproduce slowly enough.
Yeah. You know what? Why don't we... recruit... You know what? Because this is only cost 1,200 or so. Why don't we throw in a Dwarven Blacksmith here as well in the capital?
That would be quite
useful.
Quite useful.
Agreed. Oh, lucky you. Look at that looker right there. Those flowing blonde locks on her face. Isn't that something that Froar would like?
That is just a vision of beauty, like,
oh, totally.
It outshines Aphrodite.
Of course, and Froar would get his bearded Aphrodite right there. Yikes.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, yay, and there she is, right at his bearded side. Oh man, I don't know, bearded women, scary, scary stuff. No offense to any, you know, freak show participants. Alright, bigger army is coming up. Alright, now what should we recruit? We can only do Dwarven Warriors and Miners, so might as well just fill up the ranks as much as possible, right?
Yeah, plus we need to leave something behind. Anyways.
Yeah, of course, yeah, they just leave Kibble Doom completely, you know, unguarded. Alright, our spy. Sneak. A Dwarven spy, of all things. Can you believe that? I can't.
I can.
You can? Really?
Yeah.
I don't know. I always saw dwarves as big lumbering dudes and not really light on their feet type.
You really have to be light on your feet if you're blending in.
Oh, you know what? You've converted me, sir. I completely agree now. Oh, Dwarf Cove. I can freaking tax the crap out of them now. Oh, wait. No, I'm not. I was lowering their taxes so their population will increase. That's why we were doing that. So we will keep it low. For now. And then all the monies will be ours. Okay, we have really nothing else. Like, we even have, like, units queued up and everything. And, there's really no point. I guess we could queue up a Boyer in... at... pronunciation help, please? Galagoth?
I can't help with the first word at all.
You can't... Oh, you can't see it?
No, I can't assist with the linguistics.
Oh, you just can't... Okay, so we're just on equal four. As in
yes.
Ulimbar. Whatever. Boop. Well, let's do that, too. Might as well queue up. Boyers! Boyers for everyone. It's kind of funny how it's called a Boyer, and it's four axes, pretty much. Axe throwers. Okay, another ending of the turn. Dwarves can... Hey, sir, we're back at the end of the turn. Dwarves can get special mercenaries, you say?
Yeah, they can... near the Dale region, they can get Dalish archers and Dalish riders.
Really? Hmm. Oh, man. We can only recruit some Dwarven miners here. I wonder...
I think we're actually ready to move out with that.
Pardon me? We're ready to move out with this? Oh, sweet. So if
yeah,
we take everything...
Yeah, because the nearest settlement is a rebel, so... They don't really stand much chance.
Okay, so if we kind of leave these... If we just take out everybody... And, like, this unit is going to pop out real soon, so that should probably deal with the public disorder here in Kibble Doom, right?
We don't really need the miners.
No? Screw the miners?
Yeah, okay. They're more or less garrison troops.
Oh, okay. So take out the three units of miners. Oh, okay. Then I don't need to recruit this thing of miners, then. So just leave it with these guys? Really? Four Dwarven warriors, three axe throwers, and a Gimli?
Yeah, the nearest settlement's gonna be just, like, probably some bandits and axemen and stuff.
Oh, okay, cool. So now what should be our path? Kind of like this?
Yes.
Yes?
Yes.
Okay, excellent. Sorry, you sounded, like, unsure. You're just like, yes. No.
Yeah.
Maybe so.
We should likely try to take a few settlements along the way.
Oh, of course.
Just to boost income.
Of course you gotta take a few settlements along the way, man. Alright. What we got? Oh yeah, just our spy, pretty much. Nar. Yar. I'm gonna make him a pirate. Sneaky,
pirate
sneaky. Alright. Enough of that. More like Skippy, Skippy. Oh yeah, there we go. Man. This reminds me of my home country. The frozen plains of Canada. Yay. Alright, once again, just double checking on the building. Really can't build anything. We can queue up again, I suppose, in the capital. What do you think? We can do ballista towers, a city watch, a boyer, a ballista maker, a fairground, a mining network, or council chambers. What's your call there, Galagoth?
If we had more money, I'd say a mining network, but that would only leave us with 24 gold, so...
But the good thing is that it doesn't take... Like, it just queues up, actually, so that 3,500 hit won't hit us.
I keep forgetting that they have it like that in Medieval 2.
Yeah, I forget that too, right? So really, we won't take that hit until, like, three turns. And by then, I mean, if it really affects us, we can just not build it, right? But for three turns, we're going to really be pretty much fighting and looting like any good dwarf will do, right? So I think we might be okay.
Yes.
So
yes,
I say go nuts. Oh yeah, we should actually probably check on our new territory here-ish. Where is it? Here it is. Can we retrain yet? Oh, no, next turn. Next turn we'll be able to... Oh, we can retrain our Dwarven Miners already. Sweet. Maybe we should do that. Alright, so looks like the Free Peoples of Erador and the Orcs of Gunbad have declared war on each other. I'm surprised that they weren't at war with each other to begin with, actually. Alright, Danes Halls. End of turn, blah. There we go. Alright, Gimli, start trudging. Trudge, trudge, trudge. Let's see if you actually come across anything. Nope. So, how do mercenaries work in this game, Galagoth?
It's all based upon area of recruitment.
Okay.
So, the majority of the areas, it'll be mainly just bandits.
Gotcha.
But then, like, as I said earlier, the dwarves get some special Dalish mercenaries near the capital of Dale.
Oh. Cool. Alright, so now we're retraining in Dane's Halls. Oh my goodness, Borin now has a frickin' slaver. That's kind of dark for a dwarf, but he is a mean leader. He's got four skulls. And he has crap loyalty. Oh my god, he's gonna rebel on us. Look at that crappy loyalty. Not good.
Well, luckily we didn't really intend him to be any type of governor.
Yes, that's true. Actually, should we send over Froar over to be the governor? Because he's much more loyal.
Yeah.
Okay, he's obedient. Look at that. good for him. Good
yeah,
for him.
Yeah,
that's
better. Especially since the other guy's going to be leaving as soon as the army's ready.
This is true. Yeah, he's our smashing guy, not our anything else guy. Oh, I hope we have military access with Dale, because we're going to cut through.
Yeah, you start with everything with Dale.
Just cutting through like neighbor's kids on my lawn. Damn you kids. Get off my lawn. Alright. Balin, Gimli. Okay, everyone's doing their thing. We know where everyone is. Any more building? We've already queued up a little bit there. We're fine there. Oh, we can queue up something here in Dalen's Halls. Leather Tanner, Pig Farm, or Brewery. Ah, there we go. Leather, Pig, or Beer. What's your call, Galagoth?
Pigs.
Last time we were playing this, Galagoth suggested that there should be a mounted unit for the dwarves, like boar riders or something like that. It was
yes,
hilarious.
That would just be awesome.
It would be awesome. I would pay good money to see that. All right. Oh, we're
just
almost
like
there.
Should be like dog cavalry, dog cavalry for like the hobbits.
There's dog cavalry for the hobbits?
I wish there was.
Oh. Galagoth, I really just see mountains here. I don't see a city yet. Should I send my spy around somewhere
else?
Sorry, what did you say, Galagoth?
South a little bit.
Oh, sorry, over a little bit?
South a little bit.
Oh, south a little bit.
Because you're in a gunbat territory.
Oh, I'm deep in enemy territory. Oh, yeah, there it is. Derp, the, like, brownie, blacky sound. Oh, I see. So more like this away. Gotcha.
Yeah.
Gotcha. All right, we'll end the turn again. All right, at the top of the turn, we have more candidates for adoption for Lord Thorin. He really wants to replace his his dead kid. This one's boring here. Now, the money that we're making right now, now the wages, we're actually not making a whole lot right now, Galagoth. We're only making 1732 because of the upkeep of our army. So I'm all for just ditching this 43.
Yeah, we don't really need another one right now.
Yeah, we don't. We're already filled up on dwarves, thank you very much. Could you come back next week? Nice. So let's send Gnar. You said southish, right?
Yeah, it's in this area somewhere.
It's somewhere. Oh, I see a road. I bet you it's where the road is. Oh, damn it. I bet you that's where it is, though. Oh, wait, no, here it is. Oh, no, that's an army. Excellent. So just keep on going, like, along the coast, or kind of just straight like this, Galagoth?
Yeah, just keep going this way.
Cool. All right, keep on doing our thing.
And lucky for us, the majority of the Orcs of Gunbad's army should be preoccupied.
Yeah, with the war, with the free peoples. Yeah. Thank you, free peoples.
Sneaky assault on them.
Nice. No one suspects the Dwarven Inquisition. No one. Alright. Alright, we're back. Another turn done. Oh, look at that cute little dwarf with his tiny little beard. We have a new family member. Celebrations have broken out through the realm. News of a royal birth. Seriously, do you think the kids would have a tiny little beard like that?
I don't think you'd be able to grow hair like that yet.
Oh, we have a new mission to take a rebel settlement of Nenual. Where is Nenual? Oh, all that. Oh, down there. Damn it. Well, should we send Gimli to take that town first?
Yeah, let's take it.
All right, let's take it.
Show them some dwarven steel.
Yes. And dwarven women, if the steel doesn't scare them enough. All right.
Dwarven women riding pigs.
Oh my god, with beer in their hands and axes. Oh, beer in one hand and axes in another. All right, let's send their spy. I think, yeah, didn't I say? Oh wait, what's this? I think this is their capital, maybe. Oh yeah, there we go. Cairn
Dune. Yeah, there we go.
Found it. Awesome, so now we know where we go after we're done taking some rebel territories. Might as well do a practice range, maybe? Oh yeah, here we go. Iron crossbowmen. Neat.
Nice.
Do you think we should build that up?
Yes.
Yes. And Dwarf Cove, which used to be, what was it called? It was like Bitter Cove or Dark Cove or something?
I think it was Worm Cove.
Worm Cove. You're absolutely right. We renamed it Dwarf Cove because it's more dwarven, obviously. All right. Okay, another turn. Done and done with. Another turn, another candidate for adoption. Plain Thror, proven commander. Our money is no better. It's actually worse off than it was before, so I say decline. Do you say decline?
Yes, and that man does not look like he is 27.
No, I think he lied about his age. All right, our boyars have finished building in the Danes Halls. Danes Halls? Danes Halls? Where are the Danes Halls? Oh, all the way over in the other way. Dwarf Cove. I've been forgetting to retrain. Oh, in the Danes Halls. Oh, well. Now we definitely have enough people. So let's do that. Oh, yeah, we can do Axemen here. We can probably ditch a few of these miners, right? Or just use them as garrison. And throw in some axe holders. But that's not important. What is important is this. All right, Gimli. I think this is where they said it was. Only one way to find out. There we go. Found it. Oh, wow. It's an actual town. A rebel town. Oh, wow. And their gates are already kind of smashed. Let's attack it, shall we?
Yes, we shall.
All right. Let's do it. Oh, we can't assault it just yet. I was hoping we could assault it this turn, but we can't. But let's build a couple rams, maintain the siege. What's in there? Ooh, some hunters. Some Axemen militia. Militia versus dwarves? Please. They don't got a prayer.
Especially in dwarven specialty of warfare.
Exactly. Especially with effing Gimli at the helm. He's the commander of the Iron Guard. I have no idea what it is, but it sounds awesome.
They are pretty much some of the most elite units you can get.
Oh. There you go. Let's just double check with the whole building thing. Oh, Erebor can retrain. Let's do that, I guess. Not much else, really. And which is good, we should actually probably try to bank some money, shouldn't we?
Yeah, save up some cash.
Save up some monies, even though we will get more with that, with those mines. Okay, let's, I guess we can just end the turn, eh? Oh, wait, our spy here. Now, do you think our spy should try to infiltrate? Probably not, Carradine, he'll probably die. He's got a 64% chance, but he has a 77% chance on spying on this army, if you want to try that. Or should we not? You know what, if he just hangs up close to them, we can see what's in there anyway. Orc Marauders and a Ballista. Cool.
Yeah, really only the Ballista is anything to be worried about.
Yeah, and besides, we located their capital. That's all that really matters. Now we can just kind of hang out here, set up a tent, try not to get killed by Orc Raiders. You know, fun times. He'll be like on vacation. Except they'll be a not vacation at all. Let's end it. Alright, so at the beginning of the turn, we showed that we have a military report, and that the first stage of war preparations are complete. The facilities and manpower required to hand dedicated combat units are now available to us. Do we have new buildings now, dude?
I believe we can advance more now.
Oh, we can just advance more now. I see. Well, let's see if any of our buildings can actually advance more. It looks like we have this catapult maker. I think that's new. Maybe not.
And yeah, that wasn't there.
I guess we haven't really evolved up our tech tree enough to really see the changes, I suppose. Oh, well. Oh, a new family member. Froomed. With his little... He looks just like the last one. All dwarves look alike, I guess, when you're racist. let's just finish retraining what we got here. There we go. Don't have a ton of cash. Well, we're making more money than we did last turn, though, which is good.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah. Is it because the mines aren't even done yet. We're going to be making the next 470. Holy crap, a turn. Mines are awesome. Go figure, eh? Okay. You know what? Let's not mince words. Let's actually fight this damn thing, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. All right, so I'm going to just give her a little quick save, and let's assault.
Throw some axes in some people's faces.
Oh, yeah, I get to use these axemen. I'm so excited. So Spear Militia, Axemen Militia, oh, you're screwed, buddy. Oh, a bunch of Huntsmen, though. We're going to have to charge in guns blazing, eh? Because they have a bunch of archers. Okay, that's fine. We can do that. No, we're not going to auto. We're actually going to fight.
Swarms plus Coast Quarters equals win.
Equals win. Well, unless you're not the dwarves.
Oh, yeah.
The mightiest man may be slain by one arrow, and Boromir was pierced by many. Pippin, membership of the Fellowship of Denethor. I liked Boromir. I don't care what anyone says. I was a fan.
He was the most skilled.
Agreed.
Of the Fellowship.
So, we did this off-camera, but Galagoth and I have both agreed that a little flanking attack is necessary, so we have our main force here with Gimli and his Dwarven Warriors. Where is Gimli, by the way? There he is. There he is. They're going to do kind of like a main force thing here, and then there's going to be a flanking attack on the right here. We're going to sneak around and cause a little bit of problems. So let's start this battle and do this and move these guys over here. And the really nice thing about this, Galagoth, is that I'm going to have like two sets of eyes playing this. I can't wait. Actually, look what they did. They set up all here. Oh, now they're running back. Oh, except for these guys. Oh, sweet. You know what? I'm going to bring out my freaking Dwarven Throwers. Maybe throw some axes over.
They got some cojones.
Yeah, they do. They're going to have some very dead cojones soon enough, but, you know, whatever. Whatevs. Okay. Yep, they're screwed. They should at least kept their archers here, don't you think?
Yeah, get some pot shots.
Yeah, pot shots, and maybe even try to like burn down my crap. But nope, they're gonna just be stupid and die.
Possibly get a lucky hit on Gimli.
Yeah. Even though that would be a horrible way for a dwarf to die. Yeah, no, it doesn't look like they know what the hell they're doing, so I'm gonna take advantage of that. Alright, might as well move Gimli and the other guys up too. There we go. Now we play the waiting game, which kind of sucks. But good thing for the viewers, is that we'll probably edit all the boring crap out. Oh man, I could totally bring my Dwarven Throwers this way and completely screw with them, but they're running away again, so who knows. Alright, what's the range on these guys?
I'm not sure. I actually haven't gotten to use these guys yet.
Really? Okay, well, I guess there's only one way to find out, right?
Yeah. I've been mainly playing a Sylvian Elf and Gondor campaigns.
Oh, nice. Nice, dude. Oh, there we go. They have range. Stop. And start hurling those axes, baby. I hope they don't need line of sight. Okay, do it. I want to see this. Oh, I see. They haven't had a chance to get the animation yet. That's fine. So right now it looks like arrows. Oh crap, my dudes are getting shot at by the towers.
Towers.
Okay, so you know what? We'll just save them for right now. They don't need... We'll wait for them when they're taking pot shots at my Dwarven Warriors on this side. Then we'll move them up and cause a little of the old ultra-violence. Alright, how are we doing on this side? Aha, they don't even see us coming. Suckers. So I imagine a really good tactic for this is to have the Dwarven Warriors fight and have the Dwarven Axemen kind of hurl their axes over their buddies into the enemy lines.
Yeah.
That seems like it makes sense to me.
You can press them as able infantry. They are dwarves.
They are, yeah. This is true. Wait, slow down. Axe throwers are dwarves? I thought they were just hobbits with fake beards trying to blend in.
Our men have reached the gate. Maybe they are.
Sweet. I think these guys are going to hurl some more axes at these dudes. Let's see if we can't get a kill shot. Oh, yeah. There we go. Blarg.
Can't stab with an axe.
Yeah, these Dwarven Warriors are taking the fire now because they want to, you know, have us not Okay, so let's bring up the main force. There we are. Oh, and there we go. There we go. Gorgeous. I love the how they use the Scottish faction thing for Scottish faction, you know, voiceovers for the dwarves, which is, I think, is as applicable as you can get.
Yeah.
All right, so these guys are dropping the ram, so let's get ready to charge in, shall we? Oh my god, have these guys broken already? No, they're just running. Okay, come on, guys, I want to charge. There we go. Go, my little dwarven warriors. Go, go.
Oh. The march of the short people.
Nice. Nice.
You can also recruit Ents.
Ents? Are you serious?
Yes.
The dwarves can recruit Ents?
Yeah, I don't know if everyone can recruit them, but I'm pretty sure all good factions can.
Oh my god, that's amazing.
You just have to go to the Fangorn Forest.
If we remain true and steadfast, victory will be
sweet.
Ours.
Operation Pinch These Bastards In is a go. Okay, so on this flank, we're going to have these dwarves take care of these huntsmen. Oh my god, they have no chance. They haven't a prayer.
I really want to know what they're thinking running at dwarves.
It's a good idea. It's really not. And then what's going on over here? I'm getting slightly bottlenecked, but they don't really have a chance either. Look at that. Look at that gorgeousness.
Yeah, highly disciplined dwarves versus some rabble.
Rabble is exactly what they are. No, I don't. No, don't do that. Alright. Oh, they're trying to kill us with fire. That's not really going to work.
You don't burn a dwarf with fire.
No, you do not.
Not want to damage that beard.
Yeah, he Things set my beard on fire. Kill the lot of them. Alright, come on, guys. Yeah, just break over here. I'm surprised these guys haven't run. Oh, there we go. They're wavering. They're almost ready to GTFO. The nice thing about Medieval 2 Total War is the combat is a little bit lower, so you get to see all this pretty stuff going on. Pretty, pretty warfare. There we go. Alright, so I've jockeyed position here, so now I can kind of hurl. You see how I kind of have a pocket of, like, where I can target them? So now they will die even faster. Yeah, they're kind of like javelin throwers.
Have
you ever seen
Hogmoth used in a night battle with flaming arrows against the castle?
I don't know. Maybe they think dwarves are made of wood. There we go, and they broke just like that. I love it. Keep going, guys. Dwarven throwers, jockey position here now. Sexy. How are we doing over here? Oh, we won, as you can tell by the screaming dead men and the dwarves eager for more bloodshed. Okay. Yeah, just go there, and I'll bring up my axes right here. So now pretty much the town is ours, and this is really just a matter of time.
Time to mop up.
Time to mop up. Look at all these running dwarves. Actually, this would be quite terrifying to me if I was, like, say, that guy in the blue right there. I would not be running towards them. Oh, I would... Oh, no, he's not dead yet. Now he is.
I'd be sitting in a house, locked in the door, getting ready to go onto the roof.
Yes, exactly. A roof is a good tactic. A roof is a good place to be. Victory will be ours. Alright. Sexiness.
I really wish you could put archers on the roofs.
Oh no!
Oh, what just happened?
The fire killed like 5 of my dudes. Oh no. Ooh. It killed like another 3.
Oh, they got good shots right there.
Yeah, they do. You should limit their shots, I think.
Only half the enemy force remains.
Actually, we're gonna bring my throwers a little bit further back. Bring up these guys here. There we go. I'm surprised this infantry is... There's only four of them left.
Pretty hardcore.
Yeah. That's weird.
The morale tends to be kind of high for the bandits in this mod.
Does it? Yeah, you think... Yeah. You, my intuition says that it wouldn't be that high, but what can you do, eh? Alright, let's do...
The enemy general
lies dead.
Oh,
there goes the general.
Let the crows have
one dead general.
Bones, and let our swords have his men.
Elven generals are pretty bad.
Are they?
Yeah. I had my my general stupidly run outside of my town during a siege battle. Like, just him. Just the actual general. The rest of the bodyguard stayed inside the town. But because he was out there, they wouldn't start firing anymore. But he's in there with, like, a crowd of, like, hundreds of goblins. Just, like, slaying them. And then, like, it took, like, 10 minutes before they finally killed him.
Wow. So, yeah, this battle is pretty much won. I have them, like, completely flanked. Well, we have them completely flanked. Yeah, they're kind of screwed. So, actually, you know what? No. We're gonna just watch over this carnage, damn it. Why not? Might as well. I don't know what else to say. Although the freaking Lord's Guard or this Dwarf Guard, these Dwarven Nobles, God, they look badass. Like, look. That's amazing. That is sexy right there. Let's see if we can't find Gimli. He's probably covered in blood in the thick of it, so what can you do?
I think he's at the back.
He's in the... Why would he be in the back?
Our men have taken control of the city.
There we go.
I thought I saw him.
Oh, is that him?
Is that him right there?
No, I have no idea.
Yeah,
that's him. You know what it is? It's not because he's a coward or anything. It's just all the other dwarves, he just can't get by.
He's like, damn it, let me through.
Let me through?
Or snap something.
Oh, very cool. You're absolutely right. I did not take a whole lot of losses there. 11%, and that's really good for a siege battle, actually. But these guys really didn't have a prayer to begin with, so, I mean, what can you do? There we go.
And these guys are actually tougher than, like, the basic lower-tier warp infantry.
Fair enough. There we go. A mighty victory. A mighty victory. Alright, so we lost 105 and killed 608. No, 508, sorry. Alright. And here we are, taking Nenuel? Nice. There we go. And let's... what do you think we should do, Galagoth?
Well, they were humans, so we don't really have any reason to exterminate them.
Mm-hmm. So occupy?
Yeah, just occupy them. We'll be benevolent.
Perfect. Excellent. And Galagoth, I think since this is a buddy LP, I would like to name this town after you or whatever you decide. So what do you want to call Nenuel?
Why don't we call it Gothland?
Gothland?
Yeah.
I like it. Gothland, where everyone cuts themselves. Lol, lol, lol. No, just kidding. Alright, so what do we want to put in... We'll repair the walls in Gothland, but what should we build
Let's
here?
Let's say roads.
Roads? Alright.
Because the very thing will just help us get to the next area.
Beautiful, and we got ourselves 2,500 gold coins for taking...
Nice.
Well, now Gothland. And, yeah, excellent. So we're gonna call it a session here, folks. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you next time. Go ahead and say bye, Galagoth.
Bye. Goodbye, people of the YouTubes.